remember him. And so he's going to bless us again today. Jay Borkin playing a soprano saxophone. God bless you.
Thank you. Everybody say, yeah!
Yeah!
forever. And one day he's coming back. Glorious day. I say, yeah.
Yeah.
He's my rock.
He's my rock.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
He's my rock.
He's my rock.
My savior.
Yeah.
My healer.
He's my rock.
Provider.
He's my
covenant keeper.
He's my
rock. My mighty battle back.
My
strong tower.
He's
God all by himself.
He's
God all by himself. I say, yeah.
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 He's my rock.
I say,
yeah.
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 Yeah. He's my rock.
From these verses that you have read, I want to talk about again today, which is sermon number 2, the Bible. The Bible is our guidebook.
Amen.
What is it, friend? Well, Mr. Saxophone, would you come here? Thank you so much. In Sacramento, we have 2 or 3, I know, houses in Elk Grove. And we have one over there where I live. So we're giving you an invitation to come back home.
Amen. Amen. I receive it.
He was. The young man was a blessing.
Amen.
Now whether you all know this or not, he could have been too tired to come because he could have been playing last night in the one that you all do to. And you said?
Amen. God be the glory.
God bless you. We appreciate you. God bless you.
Amen.
Friends, I went somewhere a couple of years ago with someone in Sacramento, and they was one of those persons that knew everything. So he said to me, I said, you have the address? I don't need it. Sound like somebody else, I won't call no names. And so we went, and we just drove. I said, we've been riding for an hour, so where is it? And he said, I'm going by my, what's that thing that you have on your car now?
GPS.
Who?
GPS.
Yeah, he had a GPS, all right. So he said, I'm going by that. What happened was, in his following that, it's something happened, he had a mixer. And he went to another direction. When you are born again, and listen very careful, it will help you. When you are born again, I don't care what kind of degree you have, and I don't care where you live, and I don't care what you have. When you have been born again, you read this Bible.
Amen.
Not when you get ready to come to Sunday school. Some of the laziest people in the church is Sunday school teachers. You don't get your lesson on the Saturday night.
Right.
You start on the Sunday when you finish.
Right.
The Bible is our guidebook.
Yeah.
It's our reference book. It is, if you read it, a lot of people get tired in church. I'm tired. The reason you get tired, you don't hear from heaven every day. Read the book. In this book here that I have, I don't know the one you all have. In this book, whatever you need, I don't care what it is. This book would guide you to what you need. Now let me go down where you live. This book, if you listen to this book, you would not be marrying a man that doesn't love you, just want what you have. If you listen to the book. If you follow this book, you won't owe everybody in California. Let me go again. Percy, you got how many kids? Percy has three kids, him and his wife. If you follow this book, Percy, your kids doesn't have to go off to school and you don't have no money. When school is over, they owe $100,000, and he knew he didn't have no money. He said, well, I'm going on faith. Let me tell you about faith. You can't undermine God's direction in your faith. Now, let me prove what I'm saying. A man was going to build a house, and the Bible says he should first sit down and do what? Count the cost. You might not be able to build no house. You might have to buy one that's already built. Amen. Let me give you this. When I was 18 years old, I had been taught all of my life about how to handle your life. I went to a school in the country, and I didn't like it. I don't like the country. You're different from me. I don't like all I like to go to the country and get what I want and come back into the city.
Right.
I don't like the country. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just I don't like it. And so my mother came in the room, in the dining room, and we was reading because we had to get our homework. If we didn't, we got some other kind of stuff. And so she said to me, son, she called me by my nickname. I can't give you that one. And so then she said, son, this is your last year going to Sand Hill. And it went through the eighth grade. And so I had been there the second and third and fourth. And so she said, I'm going to send you to Walnut School in Summit, which is in town for us. And I said, but Mama, I don't know about two or three people at that school. She said, all you need to know is your teachers. You don't need to know nobody else. And she says, the reason I'm sending you there, parents, I hope you listen. The reason I'm sending you there, she said, there is gifts on your life. And here I thought, what gift? The only gift I'm waiting for is to be 18 so I can go to Chicago or New York. So she says, you got one of your gifts, you're going to have to help people. I said, I didn't say nothing to her. I said to myself, help people? I said, well, Mama, what am I going to do? Whatever the Lord wants you to do. But you will never get out of it. When I was in Chicago after I was 18 years old to the saxophone, that's why I can say this. I had a calling on me at 14, going in 15, and I did everything I could to get rid of it. You've been on 1951 Hollywood Boulevard all your life. I came from somewhere. And so I said, Lord, help me to hold off from preaching until I'm old so I won't have to do it. I'm trying to talk to you about this book. Now, I have always worked in the church. Always. When I was dating, a young lady, she said, you go to church too much. And the Spirit said, she's not the one. She's not the one. She had everything else to look like, but she wasn't the one.
Right.
And then when I was started dating the one, I said to her, I said, now, every time we go to church, we have to give some money. And she said, well, that's fine. I have to do that. I said, we have to give in the Sunday school. We have to give in the mission. We have to give in the offering. I didn't have no job. My mama didn't let me come to church without having some money put in church. And so she said, well, I have to do that too. I didn't tell her anything. I said to myself, Holy Spirit gave you to me and you don't even know it. I had told her. And so I said to her, I got that from this. I said to her, whatever you want to do for your mother, you do it as long as we can afford it. Because I'm going to do for my mother and father what we can afford, and you need to know that before we get married, because if you ever try to block me from helping mom and daddy, we won't be together. No, I don't care what you say. You see, you didn't read this. You didn't read this. Let me talk to the saxophonist. When you got married, this book said you must leave who?
Mother
and father, because he didn't want to get you mixed up. And you must cleave, or in your language, you must hang on to your wife. She trying to move, hang on her. Don't let her go nowhere. And if you learn this, it's in the marriage world, if you learn to hang on to who God gave you, you won't have so many problems. All a woman wants from you is to be loved. I know what you think, but you're crazy. If a man loves a woman, according to this Bible, that woman will walk on Lake Michigan for him. If he loves her. And a woman knows the difference between loving and making love. And the women say,
yeah.
All of that, all what I'm telling you is in the book. In the book. And then if it wasn't in the book, I was married almost half of my life. And so what we are missing as Christians are missing, are reading this book. Where is Joyce? John, how long you been knowing me? Speak it loud. What she said, so long she don't remember. But Joyce, not there. Tell the, stand up, Joyce, and tell the church. How many times have you ever seen me? Stand up. How many times you ever seen Pastor Williams, one of your statement's friends, act the fool? And sometimes I felt like it, but when I go home and read this, I can't do it. And when you tell Ephraim, Pastor William, Brother William, when you tell me this is just the way you are, you've been like this all your life, you are not submitted to Jesus. Let me give you some, let me get back on this marriage again. My wife went to San Francisco, her and her sister. And so she came back, and she was smart. She said, honey, I thought about you, and I saw a suit. I know you like, so I brought you a suit. And I thought to myself, now what else did you get? And she said, I was so blessed. Everywhere we went, there was a sale. And she said, and this was half price, and this is 50%, 30% off. And this is, but she had what she did, she said to me, I'm treating you so you don't bother me. There's no man, I know he would never admit this, there's no man smarter than a woman. A woman is laying in the bed with you, and you're sleeping, snoring, and she's thinking. But if you read this, you will know that. And the book is a guide to the believer's life. Amen. I I've never been mistreated in my life until I became older in the church. I was mistreated in the church in Chicago, and the reason I didn't respond, because I had been taught, if you don't hear nothing,
don't say nothing.
I know these people were crazy, so why should I respond? This book would keep you from being in debt.
Amen.
Well, let me prove what I'm saying. I said to you, members of this church, I said in this year, like this is some time now, I said it is November. Many of you all ought to remember. We owe $1.something million, balance of this church. This time next November, we're going to pay it off. I didn't get one amen. Now, let me tell you something. Because I followed the book, we didn't pay it off a year next November. We paid it off in August.
Right. Amen.
You have to be responsible for what comes through your hand. Somebody said, we don't need a chest like that. Whatever else we, I don't want nothing to look bad.
Amen,
Pastor. Nothing. You can look bad if you want to. Talking about I like you, you better get to stepping because I don't want to be bothered with you. You need to look like you're looking for something. And if you're looking for me, you better look like you're looking for something because I don't have time to chew grass. And all what I'm saying is in this book. Is you got to have some kind of standards. And so because I try to be honest, some people say, well, you know, he get upset. For, I don't get upset. I told George a few minutes ago, I said, don't have a dragon in between. I mean that. If you cannot keep something moving, you need to be moved yourself.
Right.
We don't come to church to play.
Right.
They play the organ and the piano and the guitar and all that. They play that to help move us on.
Right.
But we come to church to worship.
Yeah.
Now let me share with you this business of worshiping. You many people don't worship on church on Sunday morning.
Right.
They are here, but they don't worship.
Right.
Worship. You preachers ought to get this and respond. You worship God out of your heart.
Right.
Out of the heart, you worship him. And then as grace moves you to worship him, then faith kicks in. The reason your faith doesn't work because you don't worship.
Right. Tell the truth, Pastor. Tell the truth.
You should never come to church and go home talking about I didn't feel nothing. You don't have nothing in your heart. Because what's in the heart does what? Come out. I had a hard time sitting here when that young man was blowing that saxophone. That something was on the inside that moved me. But I had to fight to hold it down. Friends, you cannot enjoy God and don't read this.
Right, amen.
Right. Amen. And let me shock some of you, and Percy knows about it, and Lamar knows a lot about it. If you read this right and pray right, a lot of stuff happened to you, you'll know it before it happened.
Yeah, right. Amen.
But because you don't study this, you don't know that. Let me really get down to where you live. In this book, our guidebook, it's a how-to book. In this book, friends, the Bible teaches you it's more valuable than your mansion.
Right.
It's more valuable than all the money you got in the bank. This book, the guidebook. It's more value than all the degrees you will ever have. Because if you got some degrees and then you're a Christian, born again, and study the book, you become smart. Let me prove it. I know what you're saying. I don't believe that. Yes, you believe what you want to believe. That's why you're in the shape you're in. When you're born again, you start to believe in Him. Him. I have, and I told you this before, I have never been, and I never will be, I've never been a racist. You say, but that's white, but no, you got a lot of black racists. I know some. I've never been a racist, and let me tell you why. In the Bible, you read it. God saved us so we can show the world that we love other people like He loves us. The love that God shows us is supposed to be manifested and put outside for somebody else. And it is anti-Bible to be a racist and being a Christian. Amen. You can't be a Christian born again, loving God and praising Him and growing in grace, and you are a racist. You can't be that. Let me throw this on you. This will help you to live long. It's 50-something times, it's a commandment in the Bible about love. Love to the believer is a command. Love is no such thing. I'm praying and I love them more. Yeah, that's not going to work. He commands us to love one another. And some people say, well, a man left this church because I wouldn't make him a deacon. I'm not making him anything. Right. I'm watching to see what he has so I can know what I can get out of him. I can't make you love nobody, and God is not going to do it. You are commanded by Him automatically to love. And the deacon said to me, well, if you don't make me no deacon, I'm not going to be able to stay here. I said, where do you live? He said, in Elk Grove. I said, well, you know how to go home. You got to believe what you have received. This is the book. Let's talk about this love business. See, when God saved us, church, listen careful, He came in us. He lives in us. And by His living in us, we have to help Him to grow us to match the spirit He saved in us. We have a dead spirit, but He saved it, and we grow with that with Him. Amen. A man came to my house a few weeks ago to do something. His company was to send him. When I opened my door, he jumped back. I said, what's wrong? He said, I didn't expect you. And I said what I said to him when I said to you. I said, the reason you didn't expect me here, because I'm black. I said, but the money I'm going to pay you for doing the work, it's not black or white. Right. He said, oh, no, I didn't mean it like that. I said, you don't tell me what you mean. I know what you meant. The more you read this, the wiser you get. If you want to stop gossiping, read this every day. Personally, if you want to be kind, loving, sweet to your wife, read this every day. Yeah. Don't tell me you're a preacher. You can be 10 preachers. Right. And don't know this? Amen. It won't work. Right. No, sir. But Brother William, when you get there, you can't go to church. What you going to do? Somebody going to bring me. I'm looking out for that now.
Amen.
If I'm alive, I'll be broke. You know why? Because let me tell you why. Please, please work with me. This book says that I'll never leave you, not forsake you.
Yeah.
What it means, He's not going to leave me because I got sick or got old.
Yeah.
In fact, the Bible says He's never, I was young, says David. Now I am what?
Old.
But I have, listen what he said. I have, what word he used? Never seen the righteous forsaken. Not the churchgoers, but the righteous. Now, let's come back. Let's come back. I was accused some time ago that I was trying to make you all somebody else. I didn't want you all to be who you really were. And I said, wonderful. I don't want nobody in St. Paul to be like they used to be.
Right, amen, amen.
I want everybody to move up a little at a time, a little higher and a little higher. And I said, if I was playing the lottery and won $150 million, I'd build a recreational center for the members. They can come and nap, play games, and I'll allocate limousines to bring them. But I don't play the lottery. So God has provided somewhere where they live, they can enjoy peace. Look what happened to what's in the book that you don't read. It's a book of judgment. Yet it's a book of mercy. It is a book of instruction. Yet it's a book of inspiration. It is a book of commands. Yet it is a book of choices. It is a book of condemnation. Yet it is a book of glorious hope. This is some kind of book. Okay? It's a message of forgiveness. Now let me comment to you. You quit lying to yourself, whoever you are on radio land or in church. Quit lying to yourself. You're praying to God, feeling the Holy Spirit, and you're making some money and you refuse to forgive. You are lying to yourself unless this book is not right. The devil can bless you. A whole lot of rich folks rich and they don't know about God. Don't let nobody fool you, tell you the devil can't bless you. But it just won't last.
Amen.
Temporarily. Amen.
Amen.
What is it that you can't forgive? What is it? What have you done? When the man that cussed at my mother, I went to his funeral when he died. I wasn't going to hold that against him. It wouldn't affect him. It would affect me.
Yeah. Right.
Amen. You quiet now. Your unforgiveness is toxic in your body.
Right.
I don't care who you are. Well, I don't like her. I don't like him. I sold a couple some years ago. A man left his wife for another woman. And so she said, we used to be friends. She took my husband. Impossible.
Right.
Nobody can take no other person.
Right.
They submit to them. And you all, what is it? If somebody take your wine for your husband, go home and get you a Pepsi. And when you get it, drink it slow. Why in the world you want to worry about let lose your mind or somebody because they left you? In fact, you ought to be shouting because if they left you and you was what you supposed to be, they were crazy anyway.
Right.
Let them go. Okay, let's look again. We're talking about this book. It's this book is a message. It's a message of peace for the trouble. It's in the book. It is a message of joy for the sad. It is a message of victory for the defeated. It is a message of help for the struggling. It is a message of courage for the fearful. The Bible is a message of faith for the unbeliever. It is a message of welcome for the prodigal. I don't care how long you've been out there. If you listen to the word, this book will bring you home. Amen. Amen. Now listen what happened here. Let's go back to the text. It said, this is what it says in my Bible. It says that when Jesus, look what he went through with. Let me back up. Jesus came on earth to pay our penalty. He suffered and he died. Everybody saw that. And yet he said to his disciples, I'm going to rise again. He taught them as he went. They didn't hear him like some Baptists. He said, I will never leave you. They said, why are you not going to leave us? Now he's dead. You see, you didn't read the book. He says, I rise again in the book. And so when the time came after they killed him and dropped him in a barred tomb, now look what the book said. You read it. It says that an angel, that's why you can't outthink God, came from heaven and rolled back the stone. And when he rolled it back, Jesus got up. And the guards was frightened because he looked like lightning. He was so light. And when he got up, that's why I love him, he didn't run. He pulled off his grave clothes. And he pulled them off slow and folded them up and laid them to the side. Then he walks out. Now, ladies, there wasn't no such thing as women being in with men. Not in that day. That's why you should love Jesus for everything you got.
Yeah.
Jesus told the men wasn't there. Jesus told the women to go to Jerusalem and tell them, I am alive. Now, in going to Jerusalem and telling them, when he got through all of that, he made sure that you thought there was his enemy, knew he was coming. Who was that? He made sure that they tell Peter. Now listen to me, St. Paul. If it had been us, we wouldn't have never told Peter because he denied us when we needed him. But God saw in Peter what you don't want to see in other people. The young girl that prayed this morning, I was moved when she asked. Yeah. I was touched when she prayed.
Yeah.
You must learn to read the book. Amen. Some people in this church, they want to do something. And they use names. And we can't use the names and we can't tell you why. Amen. We just tell you not now. There are some people that as long as I'm Pastor St. Paul, will never come here unless they repent. And this is the book. Don't preach to me and you're raising hell and drunk last night. No, you're not. And I'm not going to be bad to you. I'm going to be kind and loving. But you just can't come here. That's the book. Many of you sit in church and you refuse to do anything. Did you not know? You don't know what you're doing? This book says we are saved to help save others. And we don't want to do nothing. And then some of you got the nerve to say, well, I go to choir rehearsal for an hour, I give him an hour. You can't give him no hour. Who are you? You need to do ministry. If it takes 2 hours, he's the one giving you. You didn't get me up this morning. You didn't start me on my way. You didn't bless me to have my oatmeal and toast. He made a way for me through this. It's in the book. I hate to go to choir rehearsal. Stay home. Bring that evil spirit. The choir would not have a good rehearsal.
Right.
That's in the book.
Amen.
Why other people can't disagree with you and you get angry? They disagree with Jesus. He loved them. Friends, there's nothing. The commands is to love ye one another. Love us. We to love each other as if we the only people on earth. Because it's a command by God. Amen. And the reason we don't so hard for us to love each other, let me name some people. I have a relationship that I built with Aubrey Tennessee Holloway. That relationship can never be broken unless he breaks it. And he's not going to break it. He is too old to be silly. Let's face the truth. And the reason many of you don't get along, you refuse to build a relationship with Jesus. And if you don't have one with him, you're not going to have one with nobody else.
Tell the truth, Pastor. Amen.
I used to cry. Why? Cry. Why is it that people didn't like me? I wasn't doing nothing to nobody. And the Spirit said to me, it's not you. It's jealousy. I haven't cried since. That's been some years ago. Jealousy is dangerous. It kills your spirit that God has put in you. Amen.
Amen.
I don't ask people very much, will you do anything? I don't do that. I say we have a need for Tom, you to do 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He's not doing anything else. He can take the 1, or the 2, or the 3, or the 4. That's my job. Nowhere in the Bible has God ever told you to pass or to beg you to do anything. He said, I am to give some instruction. And if you want to build a kingdom, you have to listen. Amen. You said, I just don't like to be around Pastor William. You're going to be around some kind of pastor before you die. And if you don't, when you die, he's going to preach right here and say he was okay, but he wasn't faithful. I wish I could get you all to read this book. It's our guidepost. Amen. Let me give you a personal statement that happened to me. I was sitting in a restaurant with somebody else. And Tom, not this Tom, 4 other people were sitting behind me. And the one that was doing the talking didn't know me. And so he was criticizing me because he said that we, as a church, should organize other churches. And we should support them for 1 year or 2 years and so they can get on their feet. And so the person said to me, he said, you want me to respond? I said, oh, no. You don't respond. I said, look what he's driving. He's driving a brand new Cadillac. Why don't he take some of the Cadillac money and organize some small churches? Why don't he do that? We help support people. But the issue is, we don't go around talking about it.
Amen.
Amen. We have to bury people. We tell you, before you get old and die, or before you get young and get killed, make provision to be buried. That's not the church's job to bury you. We teach you how to buy you some insurance. And if you want to be blessed, follow this book. And God will bless you. Not what I heard. I'm telling you what I know. This is a book of preparation. It's a book of inspiration. And if you follow it, you would be blessed. Amen. In closing, Quincy, would you come down? Listen, she's going to pick it up. It says, a charm, bring out the new. What else it says? Another day is what? She's going to come and sing it. Jesus was a man just like us. Yeah. But he was a God. He didn't change. It is no secret. You are sitting in here this morning and have not accepted Christ. It's no secret what God will do for you if you let him. All you got to do is to come to him. He'll take care of you. But you have to come. Okay, I'll help you. Go ahead. You may have long for added strength. Your courage to renew. Do not be disheartened. I have news for you. It is. Any questions?
The chimes of times ring out the news. Someone slipped and fell. Was that someone you?
Listen, church.
You may have long.
Listen.
For added strength, your courage to renew.
Yes.
Be not disheartened.
But listen.
For I
have news for you. Listen.
It is no secret.
There's no secret what God can do. Let him give it to
God can do.
What he's done for others.
What he's done for others.
He.
He'll do for you.
It is. Will you come wherever you are? Will you come today? Will you just come to him? Wherever you are, would you say yes? Will you come? Will you come wherever you are? It's no secret. He's public. Will you just come today? What God? What he's done for others?
What he's done for others?
Will you come today? Will you come today? Wherever you are, just come. Just come.
Good morning, church. Fall Bible study has begun. Pastor Williams is teaching from 6:50 to 7:30 p.m. Following his Bible study, there will be classes for adults from 7:30 to 8:30 p.m. We are offering classes on evangelism, discipleship, and classes that help you better understand the dynamics of mental health. If you are 18 to 35, we have a class just for you. Bring a friend. We have not forgotten our children and youth. We have special classes with fun activities for 5 to 17-year-old boys and girls. They are from 7 to 8:30 p.m. Childcare is available in the nursery. We need your help to make a difference in our community. Next Friday, we will walk for peace, pray for our neighbors, and share community resources. We will meet at the Family Life Center at 6 p.m. and walk for 1 hour. Wear comfortable walking shoes. Let's show our neighbors the love of Christ. The 9th Annual Exceptional Women of Color will be October 7th from 8:30 to 2:30 p.m. at the Family Life Center. There will be panel discussions, workshops, vendors, awards, book signings, and a Young Women's Summit. The keynote speaker will be the Mayor of Compton, Aja Brown. To register, go to the Sacramento Cultural Hub website. The retirees and senior adults are hosting a community resource fair for seniors and their caregivers. You do not want to miss this fair. You will also learn about your health plan report from the state and learn what it means to advocate for a patient. The date is October 11th from 9 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. The fair will be held at the Family Life Center. It is free, there will be guest speakers and more than 30 vendors.